Hello dear students, today again we are back with your same chapter number 6, that is fraction. So we are going to continue with the topic which I ended in part 1 video. Let's see what we are going to study today in the part 2 video. Yes, see, we have just explained you about fraction, like fraction, unlike fraction, unit fraction, proper fraction and improper fraction also. Now we are moving further, but still I'll give you just a recap of all this, and I hope you might have seen the video part 1. See children, it's very very important, you need to go through the video, otherwise you won't be able to solve the exercise questions. It's very necessary. Yes, okay, let me quickly recap. Fraction, what is a fraction? Fraction is a part of a whole or a collection. Yes, okay, what we studied, the next one was like and unlike fraction. What was like fraction? Like fraction are those fraction in which we are having the denominator same. And what are unlike fraction? Unlike fractions are those fractions in which the denominators are different. Yes, this was the difference between like and unlike. Yes, so what was the next one we have studied? We studied unit fraction also, children. So what was the unit fraction? Where 1 was the numerator, like 1 by 5, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 6. What are these? These were unit fraction. Yes, okay. So next comes up proper and improper. I have explained and improper also, but still I'll be explaining you more in this. Okay, so what do you mean by proper fraction? Let's move on once again. Proper fraction are those fractions in which the numerator is smaller than the denominator. This I explained you in part 1 video also. So in which, like I should say this as 2 by 8. Yes, means here the numerator is smaller than the denominator. Please remember children, what is this? The numerator smaller than the denominator. Like more examples I am going to give you. 1 by 6, then I should say 2 by 9, 7 by 13, 8 by 12. What are these? These all in which, can you see everywhere the numerator is small? So whenever the numerator is smaller than denominator, then it comes under proper fraction. Then it comes under proper fraction, children. The next is improper fraction. This also we have done on that day. Yes, this also we did. So let me write for improper now. Yes. Improper fraction. Improper fraction. So what are improper fraction? Let me see. Okay, now see 7 by 5. Another example, 8 by 3. Then another example, 9 by 2. So what are these? Can you see everywhere the numerator is larger? Yes, here the numerator is larger than the denominator. So what is here? The numerator is larger than the denominator. So when numerator is larger than the denominator, or you can say greater than the denominator, then it is called as improper fraction. Then it is called as improper fraction. Children, in your book there are some questions which are like converting mixed into improper into mixed. Many questions are there, and improper into mixed fraction. So now for that you need to know what are mixed numbers also. Okay, so this too is clear because I have done this in part 1 video also. Yes, so now let us see what are mixed numbers. Okay, mixed numbers. What are mixed numbers? Okay, let me write an example. See, can you see some difference in this? Yes, what is the difference? Here I can see a number and here I can see a fraction. Both are different. This is a fractional number and this is a normal number. So when it is a combination of a whole number and a fractional number, then it is called as mixed numbers. Okay, when it's a combination of a whole number and you can see a proper fraction. What is this? A combination of a number and a proper fraction. Then it is called as mixed numbers. When it's a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction, then it is called as mixed number. Yes. Now let me have so many examples. 5 whole 1 by 2, 7 whole 1 by 3, 2 whole 1 by 7. Yes. So these are mixed numbers. What are these? These are mixed numbers. Okay. So now, so see, everywhere you can see whole number is given and a fractional number. That is a proper fraction is also there. So it means it is understood that these are mixed numbers. So you will not have any confusion with mixed numbers because it's a combination of two. So you will easily understand. Only you need to keep all the definition like, okay, this concept is this. Proper fraction, numerator is smaller and improper, numerator is greater. And mixed number, combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. Only this much you need to remember, children, and you'll be easily able to solve all these sums. So I hope this is clear. Now we are moving further, children, with conversion. Okay. So like how we are converting. So here many questions are there, children. See, your exercise 6.1, you have the first question, second question, complete the table. So you will be able to answer that also. One example I am explaining you, children. This I have not given in part 1 video. See, this is an exercise question, children. Suppose you can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 boxes there. Okay. So now, if I am telling you, suppose I am giving a little shade as given here. Okay. Here. See, these 3 blocks are shaded. Okay. So now, I am asking you the answer. What fraction of box is colored? What fraction of this box is colored? So 1 2 3 1 2 3, how many are colored? 3. And total how many we counted? 12. So the total will go in the denominator, and the part which they are asking that how many are colored, 1 2 3, that will come in the numerator. So there are different examples given in your this, children. So by this you will be able to understand that what is this. Now if I am asking you another one, what is this 3/10? If it is written in words, what do you mean by 3/10? 3/10 is this 3 will come in the numerator and this 10th will come in the denominator. So this is called as 3/10. Now if I, what is this 2/10? It will be called as 2/10. Now, what is this 1 by 4? 1/4. What is this? 1/4. This will be written as 1/4 because 1 is your numerator. 4, we will not be writing 4. It is 4th. And more examples are there. 1 1/2. How will you write 1 1/2, children? 1 1/2. So you can understand it's a combination. Let's see how it will come. 1 1/2. 1 1/2. 1 1/2. 1, yes. Half means 1/2. So this is 1 1/2. 2 1/2. 2 1/2. 2 1/2. 3/4. What do you mean by 3/4? 3/4. 3/4 if it is written as. So it means total how many parts are there? 4. And out of that, how many we have taken? 3. So this is the way, children, how to write in words and in a fractional form in words how I will be writing, and in fraction how I will be showing it. So I think the box one and all also, that is also clear. So that how I have explained you. Now we are coming off with, see, proper fraction, nothing I have to do. I have to only identify. But if a question is given in improper form. So convert into mixed numbers. Convert into mixed numbers. So how? Let us see. Let me take an example by 8/3. So this is what? This is an improper fraction, and I have to convert that into mixed numbers. So let me see how I'll be converting, children. It is simple division. So denominator means by that I'm going to divide, and this is your numerator. This I'm going to put it here. Now let me recall the table of 3. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9. Not possible. 3 twos are 6. 1 has come down. How? Now see, this I have converted. So this how I will be writing it. Let's see how I will be writing it. So there is a method to write it down. So see how this will come up. We need to understand how this is going to be there. So how this is going to be there? See, it will be quotient, remainder, and this is your divisor. Okay, quotient, remainder, divisor. This is the way to write the improper fraction into mixed numbers. What is that, children? QR by D. Which is my quotient? My quotient is 2, my remainder is 1, and my divisor is 3. So I'll be writing quotient 2, remainder 1, divisor 3. So this is the way to write the mix. See, improper 1 into mixed numbers. Improper 1 into mixed numbers. So 2 whole 1 by 3. Is it correct? Is it correct, children? No. See, what is the denominator? 2. See, this was the thing which I know that you will be making the common mistake. Yes, the remainder is your 2. See, now I'll be writing it down. 2 whole 2 by 3. So this is my correct. See, children, if I'll not explain you, you will also do the same thing only. This why I have done it, and I wrote it to make you understand that there are chances of wrong. You may write this, but how will I understand that where my answer is wrong? By converting, when I'll be checking by this also, then also I can understand. So it had made me clear that I have done some mistake. There is a mistake which I need to correct. So I have corrected quickly. Oh no, this will not come 1, this will come 2. So this has made me very clear that the denominator is what? And so it means I have understood denominator is 3, quotient is 2, and this is your remainder. So remainder was 2, children, not 1. Okay, so now 2 whole 2 by 3. 2 whole 2 by 3. So I hope this is clear, children. So let me have one more example for this. It will make you more easy. Let us have 27 by 5. Okay? Yes. 27 by 5. 5 fives are 25. 2 is your remainder. Okay? Now let me check. How will I write? QR by D. This is the way to write in mixed number, children. This is the way to, you have to first divide, then you have to write. Remember this formula, QR by D. So what is my Q? Q is my quotient, 5. What is my R? 2. What is my divisor? 5. So what answer I have got? 5 whole 2 by 5. So I hope this is clear, children. So now the next one is converting the proper into improper into mixed. It was given proper. There is no a conversion in all, children. You only have to identify improper into mixed. We have done. Now if it is asked mixed into improper, that also you should. So this is clear. Q r by d. So q will come under whole place and the fractional part is r by d. So now convert into improper fraction. Convert into improper fraction. So how? See, suppose my number is, I'm taking an example from your book only, 10 whole 5 by 6. So what is this? This is a mixed number. How we will be converting, that you should know. So how the formula goes is, children, that is q, this is your q into, this is your d, this is your, see, this is q into d plus r divided by d. So this is this multiplied by this plus this, then again this will come. So this formula, how you can write this down is, see, q into, this is your, what is this, r, then what is this, divisor, q into r plus divisor, that, and divided by see, let me explain it once again here very clearly. I think you will be able to understand. See, with this 10 into 6 plus 5 divided by 6. So it will be 60 plus 5 divided by 6. That is equal to 65 by 6. So your answer is 65 by 6. So how was it? Q R by D. This is coming like Q R by D. So how we are doing it? Q into D plus R. So it is Q into D plus R. Q into D plus R divided by D. Q into D plus R divided by D. So children, this is enough now for today. So we'll be doing it in your next video. Thank you.